So I'm back for another summer season. I still live in Alaska. I still come down during the summers and work on summer theater.
I don't know, Kyle suggested that you have everybody leave and then the real Santa Claus shows up.
So you're quitting, huh? So these two orchestra members from the University of Montana that come down. They play the first half, they come to our cast party, and then right after our hospitality, they look at me and they say, "We can't do this."
We have to tell him that it wasn't what they expected, and they quit. So they drove back to Missoula.
Well, good luck, because you have zero integrity, you worthless piece of.
So I'm gonna write about whatever the hell I want and whoever the hell I want.
I just asked for the blog to be shut down because it was obscene.
Kelly, see you through the round. See you through the
round. Hey, I'm the drunk of the theater, Jenna.
Tiana just loses her entire head and bombs.
Replace her if she can't do it.
This isn't good. This just isn't good.
I don't want to tell Kelly I told you so, but I told you so.
Obviously, she will have to be replaced if she doesn't get it together.
Auditions, it'd be awesome. That's exactly what we want to see in the show.
So she just, she wouldn't sing out or anything, crying, blah, blah, blah. So I gave her 10 minutes. I said, take 10 and figure out whatever you're doing, you know. Belted on stage. We all left the theater. We came back. It was the same thing.
Maybe she's having second thoughts.
All right, well, I guess this is it, guys. See you, buddy.
Another good summer.
Thanks for coming down, man.
Yeah.
It was fun.
Hey, what are you guys doing for Christmas?
Oh.
Staying up there?
Probably gonna stay up there this year.
Well, the summer's been fun, but unfortunately, the fun has to end somewhere. Today, we're heading back up to Alaska. Gotta get back to work up there. And just saying our final goodbyes and packing up the car and taking off.
And it finally comes the day where Pat and his family has to leave to go back to Alaska. So we start hashing out plans for next summer.
Summer's always rushed for me because I'm constantly trying to do something for the next show.
Yeah.
So it's just two musicals. Once it goes up, who cares? We have time to float or film or...
Pat only got to see two out of the four summer shows this summer. It just seems like his time down here is getting shorter and shorter.
I'm hoping eventually that Cutler Brothers can make enough money to where I can just come down here and do that for a living. When that day comes, who knows?
He just needs to move down here and do this full time for no money.
But right now we got a TV channel going on YouTube. We got a website for it. We have the theater stuff going on. We have haunted house stuff. We have comedy nights. We have musicals, all that stuff. We have all kinds of different shows.
Get in the house and you guys come for Christmas and we'll watch some football, maybe do some four-wheeling, snowmobiling up there.
Hey now, if Abel cries, he likes that popcorn.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
He's gonna go to sleep though.
Yeah. All right.
I sincerely believe that one day this will be our job full time. Just Cutler Brothers in town doing this as our job.
Bye-bye. See ya.
Bye-bye.
The money's gonna start rolling in, eventually.
Throw popcorn at each other!
Here, turn
these
on! I will miss you!
Oh, hey,
bye bye, guys.
Bye bye.
Love ya!
Party's over, huh?
Party's over. Back to work, guys.
So after the whole Tiana debacle, we head up to Rock Creek Lake for the day.
I want to film a horror movie right here, man.
It's a beautiful location, too.
No, I don't even care if it doesn't go anywhere. I just want to film it just because it would be a blast.
Rock Creek Lake is one of my favorite places to go in the summer around Deer Lodge. It's so secluded, and you don't see anyone else up there, ever.
So you can't just be the same old thing. You gotta have a kind of new concept, but me and Matt have talked about all kinds of stuff, you know. Out in the woods, you can literally do anything.
My buddy Marquise and me start discussing movie ideas. Marquise is back for his third summer, and he's just great.
Yeah, I'd show my boobs in a horror film. I'd have to be pretty drunk, though. How much are you gonna pay me?
Let's see, $135 in the case of beer, so.
Sold.
How are you getting boobs in the film?
I'll go after it.
Probably pretty cold.
You know, it's just a nice getaway from all of the stress that live theater can bring.
Then on the way out, we see this big, beautiful moose.
Hi, my name is Jim Tilley. You might remember me from the 2013 season of Theater Impossible.
They're just really awkward and the kids are like, "What's going on?" And like really upset that there's two Santas. And
they call me Moose for some reason. No clue why.
Well, it started with us calling him Tilly McCheese. Then that became Tilly Muck, then Tilly Moo, and then Tilly Moose, and then just Moose.
It's pretty ridiculous.
Basically, if you're not on stage, you're gonna be singing, period. It may just be a melody or something, but you'll be engaged the entire time unless you're changing your costume. It's not that long of a show.
So after the lake, it's back to the theater for, I guess, Tiana's Judgment Night.
Because there is a lot of, when there's a lot of stuff going on, you know, on stage, it's hard to get those words out. I totally understand. So we'll try to help you as much as we can.
I hope she does well tonight. I'd be so nervous if that was me.
Can we do the, so you don't want to sing anything else? Do you want to do anything right now? Singing?
I would rather not waste time.
Here we go. Out of nowhere, she just kind of nails it. You know, I've really been a Tiana doubter, but after watching her tonight, just wow.
You know, I've been coaching Tiana on the side. She'll do great if she just listens to me.
I knew she had it in her the entire time. It just takes someone to pull it out of you, you know? Someone to just believe in you.
I'd like to do the temple again just because the first part of me, because Kyle hasn't done it, Kyler hasn't done it. And I really want that slow motion to look really cool. You have to agree with one another. Yes, Marquise.
Are we going full temple?
Can we?
I was so proud of Tiana. She really pulled through. She had a hard time, but boy, I don't know why Marianne was giving her so many notes. I just think she should have just butted out and let Tiana do this on her own.
I've been doing this a long time. I am really tired of people not listening to me. I know what I'm talking about.
You would probably be one of the same types of people she is, but in a totally different spectrum.
So after rehearsal, I'm just trying to relax at home, and Brent, our musical director, comes in and just reams me out about how I need to treat Marianne.
So I'm the complete opposite person.
don't have the inking.
So that's good.
So she cares so much and I care so little.
It was just stuff that I don't want to deal with outside of rehearsal. I mean, this isn't new this year.
That you? Hey, Mr. Cunningham. Don't you remember me? I'm Jean Louise Finch. You brought us a bag of turnip greens, remember?
Scout.
We have always had drama throughout our history. Last year, 2015, we did the show To Kill a Mockingbird, and we had some people from Missoula come down to be in it.
Got in my car and went out as fast as I could.
And what did you find?
Found her lying on the floor. She was pretty well beat up, but I heaved her up to her feet and she washed her face in the bucket and said she was all right.
Oh my God, drama king.
Let's clear out, boys. Let's clear out of here, boys. Oh, we're going home.
Well, being more of an each time, as much as possible.
Is this a struggle?
No.
Do you have to dig very deep?
I actually do for this particular character. I'm a different kind of than this character.
I know absolutely thinks he knows everything about the stage.
After he beat her up like that, she said, yes, he has.
He's answering the question, Atticus.
Just want to make sure.
Yeah, the people from out of town were pretty fun, but, you know, after they left, they basically threw us under the bus.
Yeah.
See you, Julie. Yes.
You going, Tiscali? Yeah. Julie?
You mad, bro?
I guess, well, I was wondering if he's going home.
My southern accent.
I don't care what you do.
Because my southern accent sucks.
Okay. Have you guys ever done any of these Cutler things before?
Nope. No.
Okay, is it just exactly what you expected would be when you auditioned for this?
No.
What's been a little different? Either one of you.
What's this video
just
for
doing
you?
Well, now that I've met Kelly, it's as much as I would expect after meeting Kelly, but not when I auditioned.
It makes you go, who the hell can you trust? You know, they knew exactly what to expect. We communicated very well. We were extremely nice. My parents had them over for meals at least 5 times a week. It's like, what else can you do?
Yeah, I was so confused about that. I also thought Deer Lodge was a lot different than I assumed it would be.
What'd you think?
Oh no, I thought everyone moseyed around town. I honestly didn't think there were any cars.
They all went back to Missoula and pretty much stabbed the Cutlers in the back.
There's only one stoplight, so that's not surprising.
So we're not invited to go to Professionals Weekend in Missoula anymore. You know, some rumors were spread. But I thought we were pretty nice.
Yeah, I would think everyone's just walking. To be honest, I thought it was just a McDonald's. Because that's what I see on the interstate. That's it.
No, but this is fun. Yeah. I mean,
no, and I imagine the theater itself. I thought that,
that was always dramatic.
Professionals Weekend is where all these actors congregate to audition for a multitude of companies. And, you know, I thought Cutler Brothers offered something really unique. If you don't get into other theater companies around here, Big Fork, Fort Peck, you could still hone your skills on the stage with us. Build your resume up.
So Kelly is an alumni of the University of Montana in Missoula. They do a Professionals Weekend, and Cutler Brothers has gone to that every single year. This past year, they found a way to basically remove our passes to go to that and take away our recruiting pass to get actors to come to our place to perform. These are actors that otherwise would have no opportunities to go anywhere. You can no longer come to Professionals Weekend, basically because we don't want you there, we don't think you're professional enough. What the f***?
Dan's right, I boycotted that Professional Weekend piece of s*** down in Missoula. It's a joke anyway.
Brothers invited for Professional Weekend.
You can't be in here, sir.
That's you know it.
I don't know anything of the kind.
Cameron's always got our back when things go sideways.
That's bull.
I want to talk to someone now!
Cutlers don't understand. If someone punches you in the teeth, you punch them back twice as hard, kick them in the and then stomp on the melon.
I thought it'd be community theater, and this is something more, which is really interesting.
All right.
I mean, and it is a community theater.
Being banned from Professionals Weekend really did hurt our company.
Your stereotypical community theater, because it's really cool, because they pull people from the community who they know will do well, and what they can't get from the community, they go elsewhere, which is how we got here.
That's where they got a lot of their talent. It was a huge thing for their company.
You know, it kind of just makes you want to give up and go do something else.
I thought about it for a long time, but you know, Cutler Brothers has been around for 13 years. We're resilient. No matter what happens, we're not going anywhere.
Yeah, that's good. Just walk off. 25. Walk off the camera.
It's just mind-blowing that you can think you know somebody, get to know them very well, give them opportunities, and then they turn around and just shit on you.
I was not picking up my feet while I was turning.
I don't know.
Where's the bunny?
Arby.
There's a bunny.
He's over here.
Hi, little bunny.
Where is he?
Where'd he go?
Oh, hi, bunny.
Where's your bunny go? Say your name.
Pash is going to delete that footage.
Pashkla? Why?
I don't know what to say about the 2015 season. It really makes no sense.
Patrick. It does make no sense. We were all friends, we spent a lot of time together, and then this?
Drive away, drive away!
Douchebag.
Regardless of anything, the 2015 season was just fantastic. Mary Poppins, To Kill a Mockingbird, Chicago, all those shows were just awesome.
Kelly in Chicago did a fantastic job. Show went up great. I think it's been one of the best they've done yet.
And all that jazz.
It was a bucket list role of mine, one of my dream roles, and obviously I nailed it.
I got some aspirin down at United.
Too bad these two-faced people had to overshadow such great shows.
All right. Walk like you got up here.
Ready?
Go. Go.
But enough about 2015. We're into a brand new season, which brings brand new challenges.
Noise is off, coming to a close, and attendance has just been horrendous.
Yes, I have a housekeeper, but it's her afternoon.
Morning! Morning.
So we have the place entirely to ourselves.
Hold it, Gary, Dodgy!
Come back?
Yes, come back and go off with the newspapers.
I think it's a hilarious show. I've helped Matt with the lights during it.
You leave the signage, go off with the newspaper, and you put back the receiver.
Sorry, Matt.
It's the dress, Gary. It's the dress rehearsal.
She drank. I did the lights.
So it's the dress. We open tomorrow evening.
Well, we're all treating it like a technical. I mean, aren't we?
Yeah, it's just, it's all those words, my love.
Regardless of the challenges, I couldn't be more proud of this fantastic cast putting on this extremely difficult show.
Oh, at 1 o'clock on Wednesdays, because I've got a nice plate of sardines to put your feet up in. Because they've got the royal, what's it called on the telly? Oh, you know.
Well, you're better than that, Gordon.
Okay, thank you. Gary and Brooke, you're off. And there's Daddy holding the receiver.
It was fun. Some of the, I guess you'd say rehearsals were kind of painful. The shows were great. The attendance was crap. But I don't think, again, people not in Deer Lodge realizing what they have sitting in their pocket drives me crazy.
Well, Noise is off. It's come to an end. It was a ton of fun. I just wish a lot more people would have come and supported and watched the show.
Like I told Kelly, the crappy days, they're far and few between. Just gotta keep trucking on. It's gonna get better.
I hope that really is the truth, because we've put a ton of time, money, and energy into this little theater in Deer Lodge. It just has to succeed. There's no other option.